Right, well, the elementary is this leaving now.
We've got some little here, and you'll have time also at the end to go through and see that this part of us.
Here comes our third group of the day. This is first and third graders.
Children to come up and help me with the hand motions. Jeremiah, thank you. One more, come on up to be on this side. Rebecca, thank you. All right, we're going to learn the 6 days of creation. And on day one, God made the earth. Rebecca, you want on this side? So put your hands together like an earth. There you go, the earth on day one. But you know what? There was something else God created on the first day, and that was light. So everybody shut your eyes real tight. Shut them so it's pitch black. And on the count of three, we're going to open our eyes and say, let there be light. You ready? One, two, three.
Let there be light.
That's right. That's what God said. And suddenly there was light. And then he made the earth. So make your earth. And that was day one. On day two, God made the firmament. Now, the firmament is a very hard word. All it means is atmosphere, or the air we breathe, or we're going to call it the sky. So scrape your hand across the sky and come to a two. On the second day, God made the sky. Right? And in that air that we have to breathe, he put in something very special that we have to breathe to stay alive. What is it? Oxygen. Very good. He put in something very special that the plants need to grow. What do the plants need to grow? Back row.
Carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide. Very good. But do you know what most of the air is that you breathe? 78%. Do you know? What?
Water?
No. There's a little bit of water. Yes. Nitrogen. 78%. Okay, guys, guess why? Ready? Nitrogen keeps the air safe. If it was all oxygen, the world would have blown up. Because oxygen burns real fast, but nitrogen doesn't. Wasn't God smart to put just the right stuff in the air so that we could breathe, so that plants could grow, but that the air would be safe? All right, so that was day two, the sky and all that air on day two. Day three is the hardest one. Three things on day three. You ready, guys? First, there was the sea. Then the dry land. Then the plants grew on day three. Got it? Oh, y'all are doing well. We're going to do it a little quicker. You ready? The sea, the land, the plants, day three. Very good. So now on the earth, there's air to breathe, water to drink, plants to eat, plenty of food, and now God started making life. No, not yet. Day four was spent in outer space as God put the sun, make a great big sun, and the moon and the stars in place and ended with a four. Very good. So on the fourth day, God made the sun, the moon, and the stars on day four. Now it's time for life. On the fifth day, God filled the sea with, you want to tell me?
Fish.
That's right, fish. Wiggle your hand like a fish. And he filled the air with birds. One hand, fly like a bird, and put up a number five. That was the fifth day. So God made the fish and the birds on the fifth day. Now, along with the fish is everything you can think of that lives in the sea. From the crabs, to the oysters, to the starfish, to the shark. All of those things were made on day five, along with all the birds that fly. Then the final day of creation, day six. On day six, God made the land animals. Wiggle your hand like a land animal, walking along. And people, point to yourself and put up a six. All right, very good. We're going to fly through those days one more time. Ready? Day one, God made the earth on day one. The sky on day two. The water, the land, the plants, day three. The sun, the moon, the stars, day four. The fish, the birds, day five. Animals and man, day six. On the seventh day, God rested. Now, thank you, Rebecca and Jeremiah. Y'all can sit down. Great job. Now, God rested, not because he was tired and not
we're here at North Cobb Christian this morning getting ready to do the chapel message as the kids are all filing in.
All the other things that died, they would have just fallen over and died. They would have rotted away and been gone, except for two things. In order to turn them into a fossil, they had to be buried very, very quickly. They fell down out of the water and have been piled up on top. And then mud has come in and buried it, and then it turned into coal. Okay? Now, coal too, you have to bury the leaves quickly and deeply before it rots, so it can turn into coal. Right, next one.
Well, now this afternoon, we're at Cherokee Christian School and about ready to do chapel.
And the plants on day three. Okay, let's do it. Y'all look up. Here we go. The seeds, the land, and the plants, day three. All right, so now
We've got water to drink, food to eat, air to breathe, and all ready for life. But God didn't make the life yet. First God looked out of space, and on day four, God made the sun, make a pretty sun, and the moon, and the stars, on day four. And you know what? Psalms 33 tells us that God spoke, and it was done.
In just 6 days, God created all. It was beautiful and perfect until the fall. He first ate the forbidden fruit. Then Adam quickly followed suit. A sin and curse, then the world was cursed.
How did they dig up the fossils? Well, usually where there's a cliff, where the land's been eroded away, you can find the fossils kind of sticking out. And then you just go and dig it all away, and there you find your fossil. Okay? Sometimes you just find a tiny little bone sticking out, and you just keep digging and digging and digging and find it all. You know what they also do out west? They look at anthills. Because sometimes the ants, as they're digging their tunnels, will bring up little chips of dinosaur bones. And when they see an anthill with lots of little pieces of bone, they think, aha.